Hi everybody, welcome to this session where I'm going to show you an example where you go from the equity value to value per share when there are options and other kind of equity claims on the firm exist. Okay, so first let's remind you that when we want to deal with options, there are several ways. Treasury stock approach is the most common one in practice that we are going to go through in here. What do we do? The value is going to be equal to the equity value. Then we add the proceeds from the in-the-money options to the equity value. And then we divide it to the number of shares plus, of course, the in-the-money options that when they exercise, the company has to issue those shares and it adds to the number of shares outstanding. How do we do it with restricted stock units or restricted stocks? We just add them as the number of shares outstanding. Okay? So now let's go through this example. We have an equity value of 15 billion. The numbers in here are in million. And then we have 473 million number of shares outstanding. These are the main shares. And then imagine that you are given really the details of options. So typically when you look at the company filing, you don't have that, but I just want to show you what would you do when you have the details of them also. So if you have the details of them here, it's given to you one set of options. There are 44 million of those and the exercise price is 182, and you're given also the current stock price, which is 30. Then you have 5 million other options. So this is another tranche of options with the exercise of a price of 40 that is out there. Okay, so how do you go about it? First, you need to compute how many in the money options you have. Okay, so you want to check the stock price, compare stock price with the exercise price. Okay, so you see whenever the current stock price is more than the exercise price, that's in the money. So we have how many in the money options we have? These 44 millions are in the money. What about the second one? So we have 5 million at the exercise price of 40, but the stock price is 30, so you have the option to buy the stock at the price of 40, but the current stock price in the market is 30, so this is out of the money, and therefore so there's nothing in the money options in here. So all the in the money options are from this tranche, which is 44 million. Okay, then you need to compute the option proceeds. So out of these in the money options, if they are exercised, how much money goes to the company? Okay, so there's 44 million options, and if they are exercised and they are in the money, each is going to pay 182 to the company, and we get this number around 80. So now, given this, I can easily compute estimated of value per share. What is going to be? It's going to be equal to the equity value. Okay, so that's the equity value plus, remember, we need to add the proceeds from options. So plus the proceeds from options in the money options divided to what? To the number of shares that we have outstanding plus the number of in-the-money options, 44. Okay, that gives us roughly 29 per share. Okay, so now imagine I am telling you that there are other shares. So I just didn't see it, but now I suddenly see it that, well, there are 56 million also restricted stock units. And there are other shares that have to be issued, for example, because the company acquired another company and it has to issue this many shares. So what do you do with those now? How do you modify your valuation? Well, the thing is the same as before, except that we have some more sort of in the category of RSUs. That what would you do with them or the other type of shares? You just add them to the number of shares outstanding. So what you just need to do, just need to add the 56 million and this 15 million to the number of shares outstanding, yeah, and you get the value 25.67. These numbers look more or less the same as the numbers you have in the exercise of Twitter I have given you in page 63 of the slides on valuation. Okay, so that's essentially the answer to that. There is the only difference is that there I am not giving you the stock price. Okay, and it's the reason is that in fact there is no stock price. The company is not yet public, and you are doing that valuation when the company is still private, is going to become public. Okay, what do you do about that? That's something that we will do in the exercises afterwards when we cover the IPOs. But essentially the answer is that, well, you need to figure out whether, based on your valuation, these options are in the money or out of the money. Okay, so essentially you don't consider these ones. First, you estimate a value per share disregarding the options that would be equals to your 15 billion equity value divided to number of shares outstanding plus the 56 million plus the 15 million. So all these are the really shares that you don't need to decide whether they are in the money or out of the money. So we disregard the options. We estimate a value per share and we see that the value is around 27. The options have exercise price of 1. Okay, so given that, you know that the options are in the money. But sometimes you may need to do an iteration in very few cases where the exercise price is close to the value per share that you estimate in here. And then if you include now the options, maybe the price just goes down, that some of the options that they were in the money, it becomes out of the money. So you need to do some repetition to get to the final answer. But that's something we will do when we cover the IPOs. I hope this is clear enough and you enjoyed this session. If there is any question, please feel free to contact me or ask me. Thank you and have a good day.